Is a cellular automaton, and how does it work? What you can see here already is a cellular automaton. It is slowly evolving into a less chaotic state, but one property of this cellular automaton is that it's quite unpredictable. This is the formal and more general definition for a cellular automaton. We don't need that generality yet, so we won't concern ourselves with this definition for now. For our purposes, a cellular automaton plays out on an infinite grid with square cells. For this specific one, each individual cell has 8 neighbors, which can influence the central cell's state. There are 2 states, dead or alive, black or white. This leads us to this more simplified and specific definition of a cellular automaton. I haven't talked about how the neighboring cells can influence the cell they surround. Living neighbor cells are counted, and based on that number, conditions can be ascribed which in turn kill the central cell, revive it, or let it stay as it is. Let's look at the rules of the most popular, and quite frankly overused, example of a cellular automaton, Conway's Game of Life. The first rule is, a living cell with only 0 or 1 living neighbors dies, as by underpopulation. Rule 2, a living cell with 2 or 3 neighbors lives on. Third rule, a living cell with more than 3 living neighbors dies, as by overpopulation. And the last rule, a cell with exactly 3 neighbors is born, perfect conditions. From those 4 simple rules, unpredictably chaotic but also beautiful and lifelike structures can emerge. What you see here, for example, is called the glider. This is another simulation of the game of life. If you're interested, this is the code I used to create the visuals for the game of life. You need the CV2, NumPy and SciPy modules, together with Python 3.7. You need to import a start configuration in form of a black and white image named start.png in the same directory as the code to run it. Now let's get to the multiple neighborhood cellular automata. Like the name says, they use multiple neighborhoods to decide whether a central cell should die or live. But also, those neighborhoods have to be larger than just a regular 3x3. Not all cells in this big neighborhood are included in the count. The differences between the neighborhoods is what neighbors in this grid count towards it. Here in blue are highlighted examples of which cells could be included in the different neighborhoods. If you now want to count the living neighbors of the cell for each neighborhood, you only count the living cells that are part of the neighborhood marked in blue, and then use the conditions to decide what to do with the central cell. You go through each cell in the grid, and for each neighborhood, you count the cell's neighbors in that neighborhood. On those counts, you apply the conditions, and if they are met, you kill or revive the central cell. The example conditions are shown here. Here's an example. Given this configuration, we want to know what happens to the central cell when neighborhood 1 is checked. Here you can see there are 5 living cells, which are also part of the first neighborhood. So our count for this cell is 5. If we look at the rules for this neighborhood, we see that this means our central cell dies. These counts are calculated for the whole field at once. The cells are not updated while the other counts are still being calculated. You can assign colors to cells depending on what neighborhood they were revived or killed by. Now I will show you what our two example neighborhoods and their rules look like when simulated on a 960 by 540 grid. Here are rules for another MNCA, which simulates bacteria and how they move, split, and die. This is the close-up of one cell from a slightly different starting configuration. You can see how it does something similar to mitosis and eventually dies. All of the examples I've shown you here, you can simulate yourself with the code from my GitHub, link in the description. There's also an explanation of how to set it up. Many thanks to this guy. I stumbled upon this because of him and he inspired me to make this video. Definitely check him out. He went a step further and created SMNCAs, which have multiple MNCAs running at once. But I won't go into detail for that in this video. Anyway, here are some more simulations, and that's it from me for now. Have a great day and keep exploring.